We present Radio 4. It's 10 to 4. Choral Evensong comes this afternoon from Canterbury Cathedral. The canticles are sung to the setting in D minor by Walmisley, and the anthem, I Love the Lord, is by Jonathan Harvey.
Psalms 71 and 72.
Thank you. Thank you. would not come. Then he said to his servants, "See, Joab's field is next to mine. He has barley there. Go and set it on fire." So Absalom's servants set the field on fire. Then Joab arose and went to Absalom at his house and said to him, "Why have your servants set my field on fire?" Absalom answered Joab, "Behold, I sent word to you. Come here, that I may send you to the king to ask, 'Why have I come from Geshur? It would be better for me to be there still.' Now therefore let me go into the presence of the king. If there is guilt in me, let him kill me." Then Joab went to the king and told him, and he summoned Absalom. So he came to the king and bowed himself on his face to the ground before the king. And the king kissed Absalom. After this, Absalom got himself a chariot and horses and 50 men to run before him. Absalom used to rise early and stand beside the way of the gate. When any man had a suit to come before the king for judgment, Absalom would call to him and say, "From what city are you?" When he said, "Your servant is of such and such a tribe in Israel," Absalom would say to him, "See, your claims are good and right, but there is no man deputed by the king to hear you." Absalom said moreover, "Oh, that I were judge in the land. Then every man with a suit or cause might come to me, and I would give him justice." And whenever a man came near to do obeisance to him, he would put out his hand, take hold of him, and kiss him. Thus Absalom did to all of Israel who came to the king for judgment. So Absalom stole the hearts of the men of Israel. And at the end of 4 years, Absalom said to the king, "Pray, let me go and pay my vow, which I have vowed to the Lord in Hebron. For your servant vowed a vow while I dwelt at Geshur in Aram, saying, 'If the Lord will indeed bring me back to Jerusalem, then I will offer worship to the Lord.'" The king said to him, "Go in peace." So he arose and went to Hebron. But Absalom sent secret messengers throughout all the tribes of Israel, saying, "As soon as you hear the sound of the trumpet, then say, 'Absalom is king at Hebron.'" With Absalom went 200 men from Jerusalem who were invited guests. They went in their simplicity and knew nothing. While Absalom was offering the sacrifices, he sent for Ahithophel, the Gilonite, David's counselor from his city, Gila. And the conspiracy grew strong, and the people with Absalom kept increasing. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thank you. The second lesson comes from the first chapter of the Gospel according to St. Mark, beginning at the 32nd verse. At the beginning of his ministry, it looks as though Jesus was trying to avoid publicity, but nevertheless he got it. That evening at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons. And the whole city was gathered together about the door. And he healed many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. And in the morning, a great while before day, he rose and went out to a lonely place, and there he prayed. And Simon and those who were with him followed him, and they found him and said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." And he said to them, "Then let us go on to the next towns, that I may preach there also, for that is why I came out." And he went throughout all Galilee, preaching in their synagogues and casting out demons. And a leper came to him, beseeching him, and kneeling said to him, "If you will, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hands and touched him and said to him, "I will, be clean." And immediately the leprosy left him, and he was made clean. And he sternly charged him and sent him away and said to him, "See that you say nothing to anybody, but go, show yourself to the priest, and offer for your cleansing what Moses commanded for a proof to the people." But he went out and began to talk freely about it and to spread the news, so that Jesus could no longer openly enter a town, but was out in the country, and people came to him from every quarter. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and stood on the right hand of God. From hence he shall come to judge the quick
To hear us, and grant that we to whom thou hast given an hearty desire to pray, may by thy mighty aid be defended and comforted in all dangers and adversities, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Enlightened thy church by the teaching of thy servant Basil, enrich it evermore, we beseech thee, with thy heavenly grace, and raise up faithful witnesses, who by their life and doctrine may set forth to all men the truth of thy salvation, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. By thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Anthem is "I Love the Lord" by Jonathan Harvey. The words come from Psalm 116.
Thank you. Let us pray. We thank you, O God, for all your wonderful works and for the creative gifts you have given to all people. We offer our praise in humility and gladness for all who use these gifts to increase the richness of life, for the consecration of music to your service, and especially the work of the Royal School of Church Music, and for all things that help us to see the true nature of your creation, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We pray, O God, for your church throughout the world, especially on this day for the work of the South Pacific Anglican Council and the Diocese of Polynesia and Bishop Jabez Bryce. In this Diocese of Canterbury, we pray for the parishes of Alston with Ruckinge and Warehorn and their priest Robert Stroud. Lord, you have consecrated the world by sending your Son into the midst of it and by making all things new in him. We ask you to give us and all your people the courage and power we need to share fully in his mission to the world and to further his kingdom in the lives of men through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, make us the instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O divine Master, grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Choral Evensong came this afternoon from Canterbury Cathedral. The organist was Allan Wicks, and the assistant organist was Stephen Darlington. Next Wednesday at 10 to 4, Choral Evensong will come again from Canterbury.